We have a door. Let's see where it takes us.
Straight off the rip, you know I don't wait for the drop the rip. I go out to eat with my kids and my mama. You know I ain't dating no thotties. Okay, leave what you see, nigga. I can't name a rapper that's out here breathing. It's fucking with.
It's kind of chilly. Boo. Hey. What's good, guys? It's Ben Had. Bill Sony, can you throw me those questions? Woo! This is a paper towel. The real question.
All right, let's get these questions out. First question, how old are you? Ben Had is 22. Jordan, yours coming up next year, you know, kind of excited for that. Okay, second question. If you could live anywhere in the world, where would it be? Definitely LA. I live where I want to live. I feel like I belong here. So yeah, that's LA, easy. If you could make one wish come true, what would it be? Happiness for the world, I guess. You know, like everybody be happy. That would be kind of lit, duh. Like world happiness. Screw world peace, world happiness. If everyone's happy, they're not gonna fight. So, okay, that would be probably my wish. If you could go back in time, what would you tell your younger self? I don't think I would tell my younger self anything, just because I feel like if I told him something, he would think about it way too hard, completely change the outcome of what I have become today. Without learning from my past experiences, I would be who I am today. So I think I need to go through the lessons I'm gonna go through. I wouldn't tell him anything. Might smack him around a little bit though. Favorite holiday? Gotta be Christmas. I like getting gifts. I like giving gifts. And everyone's usually happy around that time of year. So it's pretty outside usually at nighttime at that time of year too. You look at the lights and stuff. So yeah, definitely Christmas. Who is the youngest person you would date? / would you date someone like 8 years younger or no? LMAO, asking for a friend. I'm 22. So I would date an 18-year-old at the youngest. Definitely not going under that. Definitely not breaking laws out here. We don't want no case. What is the most exciting thing you have done since you have lived in LA? Oh, man. I don't know. There's so much stuff happening constantly. And it's like every day you just don't know what is gonna freaking happen. You wake up in the morning and you're like, here we go. Because like you really don't know what the heck is gonna happen that day, who's gonna come by. Like today, for example, Asin Ray's dad was here, like just out the blue, they just showed up. So you just don't know what's gonna happen, really. What is your long-term goal? Definitely to grow. I would say I definitely need to get my fans up. So my long-term goal would probably be like 1 million on TikTok is probably my long-term goal, but hopefully we can make it shorter term. Hopefully. Tristan, nobody wants to see your, he just had his pants down. Whoa, I'm freaking trying to talk about this stuff. Next question. How many languages do you speak? I only speak English. I know phrases of stuff in other languages, like alta classe ampia is high class broad in Italian, or state zitti mangia, stranza pazza, it's shut up and eat, you crazy B word. Ow! Stop throwing rocks at me! No! All right, where do I see myself in 10 years? Probably still in LA, hopefully with a lot more money. We'll see what happens. Maybe I'll be homeless in LA. You never know what's gonna happen here. If I would have looked back a year ago today, would you seen yourself at this point in your life and living in LA? A year ago today, I was doing TikTok as a joke. I always wanted to move to LA, but I didn't know how I was gonna get there. And the year ago me was just, you know, doing it for fun. It was like, haha, I do TikTok. Everybody around me from back home didn't really support TikTok, like, or being an influencer or doing that. They look at like TikTokers as like SoundCloud rappers. If like you're like, yeah, I do TikTok, then they're like, oh, back home. So it was looked at a lot differently. I was just doing it for fun, and then I just kept going with it, and here I am. I drip where I live. It's been a crazy journey. It's gonna keep going, and I cannot wait for what the future holds. Ben Had.
bet.
They're gonna be like, this is the same dude that crashed the mailbox. Like,
I was made for this shit, rookie of the year. I wouldn't show up for the freshman list. Your swag expired, you ain't fresh like this. Shit on all my haters, I'ma make them pissed.